Solar, wind, hydropower, geothermal power, all of these are sources of renewable energy.
Renewables refer to essentially inexhaustible sources of energy from natural sources.
They don't emit CO2, we understand how to harness them, and they're finally being deployed.
These are competitive sources of electricity now. These are not some kind of far-off thing, but they are ready to compete now and increasingly are competing now in a lot of different places. The sources that have been growing the fastest, however, are wind power and solar power. And those are the ones where you're seeing a huge amount of optimism about the role that they can play in the energy system in a very clean way. Really, deployment has been accelerating massively over the last, perhaps over the last decade. And the main reason for that is because the cost curve has come down.
And they're cost competitive with fossil fuels for making electricity, a sector that's been relying on coal and natural gas.
Electricity is worldwide the largest source of energy-related carbon emissions, and it is the second largest source in the United States after transportation. Really aggressively confronting climate change unavoidably has to address electricity.
We use electricity to power a lot of things.
Buildings, hospitals, schools.
And we'll likely be using more of it in the future, too.
There's the interest in not only, using wind and solar for our traditional uses of electricity, but also for expanding electrification into things that right now run on fossil fuels. So, for example, that could be natural gas-fired home heating or cooking. You hear a lot about automobiles. It's not always sunny. The wind isn't always blowing.
We can't rely on wind and solar for all of our electricity just yet.
One thing is transmission, right?
Transmission means getting renewable energy from the place where it's made to the place where it's used.
You want to be able to get the electricity created by those sources to the population centers where it's really needed. And so that means I think a lot of people think we're going to need a lot more transmission build out in order to meet some of our deployment goals.
Plus, energy storage, like batteries, will have to improve to store excess renewable energy and enable that transmission.
Basically, just want to be able to use them in a way that allows very high levels of storage of wind and solar power, so you can deploy them at a large scale as needed, and that sort of lessens the need for backup natural gas-fired power or coal-fired power or power from other sources. Almost any projection that you see out there shows aggressive growth in wind and solar power going forward worldwide.
And we'll probably hear more about other kinds of renewables, too.
We're seeing a real strong amount of venture capital and investor interest in sort of emerging advanced forms of geothermal electricity that are nowhere near along the adoption curve that wind and solar are, but that's another source that could play a significant role going forward as well.
No matter the specifics, each of these matters for cutting back on fossil fuels.
On a worldwide basis, renewables right now are kind of adding to our fossil energy system. We're going to have to see wind and solar and other forms of renewables not only being an addition, but actually taking away the market share from those fossil energy sources.
Wind and solar are growing quickly, but renewable energy still has a long way to go. Here's what we've learned. Renewables could help us get clean electricity and power more things with electricity in the future. We need better ways of storing and moving excess renewable energy to make the most of them. But they're expected to grow a lot in the future. That said,
wind and solar are not going to be enough on their own to kind of fully decarbonize our energy system. It's going to take a whole basket of approaches, but certainly if you want to look at what are some of the kind of pillar or like foundational technologies for confronting climate change, wind and solar are really right up there at the near or at the top of the list.
Another technology at the top of the list? Electric vehicles.